Hi, I'm Stuart, and welcome to Signet Television. Well, today's temperature here in the beautiful Pacific Northwest is somewhat in the region of around 90 degrees Fahrenheit. But I'm going to show you a video right now with young Chris, which was shot a few months back before COVID changed the world and to a degree our lives. And that was a different day in question. So from this gorgeous sunny day in the Pacific Northwest, let's go back in time and see what Chris was up to over at StarCar, where it's a little bit on the blustery side.
We're here at StarCars for our most brilliant presentation of a Dodge Durango yet. Lit up with an amazing wheel and engineering lighting package that we got to help spec out with this vehicle. FST blasting away up top in the two-piece on the headliner. The V-Series smoked out for a nice stealthy touch under the rearview mirrors. As we move forward up into the grille, the action that we have going on there is the tri-color ions. Down below is the solid color microns, also smoked out, so you would not even know that they were there when they're turned off. So the whole point of this vehicle is to be undercover and covert. Single 100 watt speaker with a Durango specific bracket, so made it very straightforward, and the 100 watt output is brilliant because there is no obstruction through that front grille design. And taking care of business with this vehicle as we move further back into it. Lining out the side profile is the 5-module tracers. Couldn't forget about the third windows with the T-Series light heads and a very nice shine that they give us there. And moving around to the back of the Dodge Durango, we have RST popping away up top in duo color ions, ULF 44, and the blue vertexes. You know we love to do that when it comes to the Dodge Durango outfitting. Down below, sound off signal and action in the Ghost Rock light. And they're not set to a flashing, but actually tied into the vehicle through a reverse trigger. So a really nice way to help brighten things up when backing. Pay attention now to the flashing and the rates that we have going up here, here, and through the taillight and vertexes. This vehicle is running Wheel and Engineering and the Syncom carbide. So a neat feature with this vehicle that we can demonstrate is how the door opening is making adjustments. Switching over to a simple red flashing with the modules on the outside, a blue and the steady flash, switched over to the Ion Duos, still maintaining their thing, and the system switches itself back over, and that's because it's on a time trigger. So again, for vehicles looking to have lighting that can be adjusted automatically through door triggers, that's a really great aspect of the carbide and the OBD2 installation kit for it. To supplement the lighting when the hatch goes up, T-Series and their miniature format have worked out really nicely. The RST and its one-piece housing is a perfect form fit for the Dodge Durango and other vehicles alike. Bracketry, very specific. The contour of it with the included lip piece keeps it from chattering and no light to bleed inside the vehicle. It's also very nice for mounting accessories, in this case, the Panasonic rear-facing camera. And down below, to round out the back cargo area, we have the greatness of Truck Vault and one of their multi-drawer storage systems. A large pullout up top and offsets on the bottom. So great heavy-duty handles and the key and combination lock. Seeing as this is the first Durango that we've showed you that's outfitted with a transport system, Satina and their wonderful products are being utilized. The transport seat with rear solid window polycarbonate barrier. Up on the front end, and you will notice, wow, there's a lot of room in here. So this is the partition with the recessed center and extra leg room. So this portion here on the driver's side is not as kicked in as it is on the passenger. Solid piece window, there's lots of different options for you to pick from if this isn't gonna work. On the doors, the combination of the TPO cover panels and the polycarbonate window bars. You'll notice that there's been a nice little cutout, like StarCars does, to accommodate the side cameras. Speaking of side cameras, there's an additional Panasonic up here facing into the transport area, and just up above that, from Wheel and Engineering, a two-tone 3-inch LED light, switchable from the driver's area from white over to red. From time to time, we see comments from you asking about the partitions and how they work from the rear as far as the doors and spacing. Well, here is a great look at the side polycarbonate wraparound and cover panel. So this is going in front of the roll bar, reaching to the passenger side. So this is a completely form-fitted piece. So again, from the back end, there is absolutely no way that a hand or anything can be passed through the vehicle back to front. Gamber Johnson is the console solution that's been used along with their system for housing the docking station for the CF54. The Dodge Durango does have a factory shifter that gets reused in this console, so provisions are all provided by Gamber Johnson. That takes the guesswork out of it. Here is the control head tying into the lighting and siren system. After all, again, it is the carbide, Motorola radio, Kenwood radio, and of course, cup holders to keep a beverage or whatever else you may need to. On the passenger side, we'll have the camera swing around to give you a look at the pedestal system along with the AOI control bag module and the housing for the ticket printer. Whelan Engineering and the FST series interior light bars. They take the guesswork out of the installation process. The visor bracket specific to the headliner and vehicle sun visor attachment point. The housing contouring to the windshield is also 100% vehicle specific. But another benefit you'll find is it's a great place to mount other in-vehicle accessories like cameras or radar. WeCan products and the FST front interior bar really give your vehicle some benefits when it comes to lighting up the scheme of which you want to display. Here we have it flashing away in the dual color, red-white shifting amongst a blue-white. Nothing going on with the takedowns. This is position 2 on the slide switch. Position 3 has made an adjustment. After all, this is software programmable independently through a WeCan software, or what StarCars has done here is through that command software in the carbide system. So a really great way to shift up the lighting. But when this is not being used as a warning format, tap of the takedown switch and the entire fixture has wrapped itself over. The takedown modules in the center have a spot or more focused output to them, and the modules on the side, again, very nice and intense, but they help to stretch it out and broaden it. The takedown modules can be operated independently if you wanted to have more switching of the control, but to light up the entire front of the vehicle, takedowns and the other FST in white steady burn. Well, I'd like to thank you for joining me here on a beautiful Northwest day for a look at the Dodge Durango that StarCars has yet again done a fantastic job demonstrating their talents. To stay up to date with us on the newest of vehicle installations, products, and other great things that we bring you through SirenNet, make sure you're liking and subscribing. I'm Chris. I'll see you next time.